In this video, we're going to go ahead and give a little bit of an overview of how to get familiar with the IBM Quantum Experience. So to get started, go ahead and visit the IBM Quantum Computing page. So the website URL is right here. And you'll click Launch IBM Quantum Experience. At this point, you'll need to go ahead and sign in using your IBM ID. If you don't already have an IBM ID, you'll go ahead and make an account. After you sign in, you'll land on the IBM Quantum Experience dashboard. You'll see the machines that you have available to you. You'll see your recent circuits, and then you'll also see your results. We don't have any right now, but we will soon. Next, go ahead and click on the Circuit Composer. Once you click on the IBM QE Composer, you can build your circuits for run on the simulators or the real quantum backends. So up top, you have an assortment of different gates available to you. And then here, we have a way to analyze the circuits that we've built. So let's go ahead and do a little bit of a live demo. So here we're back at the IBM Quantum Experience Circuit Composer. We'll start by taking a NOT gate and placing it on a qubit. So these are qubits. We have qubit 0, qubit 1, qubit 2. And the state of those qubits are recorded here in the measurement probabilities. So if we drop a NOT gate on qubit 0, we can see that the qubit 0 probability is now a 100% chance of being observed, or has a 100% chance of being observed at a state 1 rather than a state of 0 like it previously was. To delete a quantum gate, we just right click it and click delete. If we drop an H gate, you can see that now we have a 50% chance that our qubit 0 is measured at a 1 and a 50% chance that our qubit 0 is measured at 0. Now let's see what happens when we take a NOT gate, we'll put it on qubit 0. We can check out the measurement probability below. So now we have our qubit 0 at 1. And now we can insert a swap gate on qubit 0 and qubit 1. Once we insert the swap gate, we can see that the value of qubit 0 and qubit 1 have swapped. So now we want to go ahead and simulate this circuit. So let's go ahead and put a couple of measurement operations, and we'll go ahead and simulate. So we're going to go up to run settings, and we'll scroll until we find the IBM QE Chasm simulator, and we'll press run. So we can see that the job was sent to the IBM Chasm simulator. We can also run this on a quantum machine. So we'll go ahead and you can see that all of them have different numbers of circuits or experiments in their queue. We'll go ahead and press on Athens, and we'll press run. We have a job waiting for us. So we can go ahead and click on jobs. And we see that we have a completed job, so we can click on that job. And as we expect, we have a 100% chance of being in state 010 when we have our first qubit, qubit 0, pass through a NOT operation and then a swap operation implemented on qubit 0 and qubit 1. We'll have to wait a little while to get our results from the quantum machine run. We can find the status of our experiments by clicking on the jobs option to the left. So we're still waiting for our quantum machine run, but here we can see our completed simulation. We can come back and revisit our results after some time, and we can see that our run on IBM Athens has finished. This is our real quantum machine run. If we look at the results generated by the quantum machine run, we can see that we no longer have a 100% chance that this circuit results in a state of 010. This is because of noise associated with running on a real quantum machine.